in early spring. And the plant beds are rather empty now. Never mind. We are here to talk about companion planting. Well, but what does it mean?
Our plants become partners. We plant together to
plant.
We plant them together to become plant buddies. Oh yes, they are plant companions. We plant together plant families, and we make plant communities in the school garden. Hold on, I know there is a difficult word for that. The one we use in science.
Biodiversity, you mean?
Yes, that one, biodiversity.
Well, you can remember our motto. Every plant is important, every plant contributes.
Right, plants are different, but when they live together in our school garden, they complete each other. Well, I guess it's much like people when we work in groups and
respect
each other. We can work miracles.
Yes, we can benefit from each other.
Okay, but let us tell you how we do companion planting in our school garden.
First, we start with seeds, because seeds are important. We make seed plants on the greenhouse and wait for them to stem and become little baby plants. That might take 2 to 4 weeks. Then we take them to the raised beds and plant them together in groups. We might have 3 to 5
different
plants in each raised bed. We arrange them in rows depending on the size they get when they grow up.
Enough said. Let's show them how we do this. Come on, buddies, let's plant together.
Plants too. It isn't good for them to be on their own. this garden bed. We have planted lettuce together with onions, but we still have some sweet chard left from our winter plants, and some beetroots here too. Have you tried sweet chard stuff juice? They're delicious. Yes, we will keep those sweet chards in this garden bed for now. We have also planted 2 rows of lettuce, 3 rows of onions, and 2 rows of radishes. You cannot see those plants yet, but they will grow in a week or so. Lettuce, onions, and radishes are good garden buddies and companions. They also get along with Swiss chard very well.
In this garden bed, we have onions with lettuce and tomatoes. Onions naturally keep away apples and other pests. This means that good companion plants for onions are any plants that often fall victim to them. We plant fast-growing, cool-weather crops like lettuce or radishes early in spring together with slower-growing, heat-loving tomatoes. We will be able to harvest our early lettuce and radishes quickly, making room for the tomatoes to take over later.
We usually plant basil near tomatoes. We can cook them together and make spaghetti sauce, but they also grow in harmony together. It is believed the aromatic oils in basil keep insects away. Otherwise, they could come near and mess with the tomato plants. It looks like the basil is the tomato's body.
Margot's garden and onions keep insect pests away from crops because they're dissected alone. So it is nice to grow them in several locations in the garden.
Radishes may attract flea beetles since they become a top crop. What we do is to leave a few radishes around the garden. Flea beetles love radishes and they will get on them easily and eat their leaves instead of the broccoli, cauliflower or eggplant. When the insects stuck and trapped on the radishes, we can take them away out of the garden. Oh yes, we can treat those insects and set plant trap like this.